Welcome to the complete FPS optimization guide for LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga on your PC and laptop. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. We will first take a look at your in-game settings before making changes to your operating system. Open up The Skywalker Saga and navigate to your video settings. Here, make sure to set the screen resolution option to your native monitor resolution. Below, disable the window mode and borderless options to get the most performance. It's set to windowed for me as it's easier to record. Below, you have the option to disable VSync when playing in full screen mode. This can help improve your frame rate, but might induce screen tearing. Set the shadow quality to low and disable anti-aliasing. If you have some performance to spare after applying the next tweaks, then feel free to increase some of these settings to get a better visual experience. You should set the ambient occlusion and screen tearing reflections to low for now, and make sure to disable image sharpening, which will otherwise require a high-end graphics card to run smoothly. The HDR output option should be disabled by default. After applying your changes, leave the game running and open up your task manager. From here, right-click the LEGO Star Wars process and select to go to Details. The main game process should be highlighted in this list. Simply right-click the process and set its priority to High. In order to reduce the CPU utilization from other programs, I suggest you end some programs from running in the background, which you don't need when playing the game. But make sure to only end programs from running which you know won't break your operating system. In the Startup tab, you can additionally prevent programs from starting up on system boot. You can then close LEGO Star Wars and your task manager. You should make sure that your graphics card driver is up to date. I suggest using the GeForce Experience application if you're using an NVIDIA GPU, but you can also use the AMD Radeon software. In the Drivers tab, simply click on Download, and the application will automatically download and install the latest driver. Repeat this step at least a few times a year to make sure that you get the most out of your hardware. When navigating to your GeForce settings, make sure to disable the in-game overlay in your General Settings tab, as application overlays often cause performance issues. Below, you have the option to enable the image sharpening option. For some of you, this option is not available as your graphics driver is not up to date. Enabling NVIDIA image scaling can drastically increase your frame rate for any game you play on your PC. After making sure that your GPU driver is up to date, open up your system settings window. Here, navigate to the gaming section. Under game mode, you have the option to enable or disable game mode on your PC. In theory, game mode should prevent Windows Update from performing driver installations and sending restart notifications, as well as help achieve a more stable frame rate while in-game. Some users have reported that disabling this option will drastically increase their gaming performance on Windows 11 or 10. In your related settings, select Graphics. Click on Browse to change some custom graphics settings for the Skywalker Saga. In your File Explorer, navigate to the drive on which you saved the game on. The file path to the Steam version is Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga, and here select the Star Wars EXE application. This will add the Skywalker Saga to this list below. When selecting options for the game, make sure to set the graphics preference to High Performance, which, in most cases, will take advantage of your graphics processor to help run the game on your system. Keep your settings window open and search for Update to get to your Windows Update settings. Make sure to check for recent updates, and in case there's an update available to you, make sure to download it before restarting your PC, which will install the update for you. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.